Hi, my name is Kim Clark. I'm an integration architect working for IBM. It still surprises me just how many times I come across misconceptions around microservices and APIs. Often hearing phrases like microservices are fine-grained web services or that APIs themselves are equivalent to microservices. These all sort of show fundamental misconceptions under the covers. And so I've created this just to really break that out and talk about what the key differences are in those two concepts. This video is part of a series of videos and parallel posts we'll be doing in the integration blog, so feel free to keep an eye on those if you want to see more of the same. If we back up a moment and just say, what is an API? An API, fundamentally, application programming interface, it's an interface. It's a way of making requests into a component. So it's the route that you go in to make those requests. In modern use, that typically means a REST API. So that's a call made over an HTTP protocol using JSON data as the payload. So let's ensure we also have a clear, crisp definition of what a microservice architecture really is. So microservices architecture is about breaking siloed components up into smaller components that are more agile, more able to be changed more easily. We can scale them in different ways. We can put resilience models around those individual components in different ways. So breaking down large applications into smaller components. So really it's about the shape and the size of the component that's within the application itself. So microservices architecture then is really about breaking things down into small components. It's really a microcomponent architecture. And APIs are the interfaces that could be used to expose the functionality in those components. But the two are separate concepts. They're not directly related. There's no particular reason to assume, for example, that if you changed your design from that of a siloed component to that of a set of separate microservice components, that it would change the number of APIs that the overall application exposes, or indeed change their granularity. Those two things are completely independent of one another. So, microservices are components that are used to build up an application in a more agile framework. APIs are a way of exposing functionality of an application, whether it's written as microservices or not. And there's no one-to-one correlation between the two. We could easily have a microservice exposing multiple APIs, or just one, or indeed none at all. A microservice component could be working on asynchronous messages, picking messages up, manipulating them, enriching them, and putting them somewhere else. There may be no API whatsoever. It's just a component of an application. We've skimmed over some pretty deep concepts here. So microservices architecture is non-trivial to understand. And when you start comparing it with things that came before it, like service-oriented architecture, and comparing and contrasting between them, that can really get quite sensitive. So there's a link at the bottom of the slide that'll give you a route to an article that describes all of these concepts in much more detail. As I mentioned at the beginning, we'll be doing various posts and videos on topics to do with integration, design, and architecture on the IBM integration blog and on the integration media channel.